So, I have the pleasure to announce Gian Franco Goeta. You introduce yourself. I do not know so much from you, other than you are a very wise person. He studied philosophy. That's where he comes from, and he is a follower of Thich Nhat Hanh. So he is much in meditation and understanding. And his first focus is wisdom, as far as I understood.
So, Bernd took a risk, inviting me here, because he didn't know me, and he just felt I might be wise. I don't know how you decided that, Bernd.
Thich Nhat Hanh told me.
Okay. So each of us has his saints. It's a privilege for me to be here with such a professional audience. I'm very much struck by the level of the people I met here. And this makes me feel a little bit anxious, a little bit, will I be able to convey you in such a way that we may create some value. We may create learning together. Learning, in my view, as a coach, is always an interaction. It's not something which is there and comes to the minds like a vase. It's something we create knowledge together. And so I need, at the beginning of my speech, to feel that I am together with you. And I ask you, therefore, I will, as all coaches do, I will ask you two questions. And I wait for your answers, okay? And the questions are these. When you read this title, what are your hopes? And what are your doubts? Doubts are more important and more meaningful than hopes, of course. But hopes give me some good feelings. So please give me also some hopes. Okay? So I need at least 5 doubts and some hopes. In the challenge we say, al tuo buon cuore, okay? So please answer with your heart.
Yeah, I would have both. I think my
doubt. One, no more than one, because otherwise we will have too many. One doubt and one hope.
My doubt would be that we just exchange pre-cooked thoughts,
Pre-cooked thoughts. And I put a question mark there. It's doubt. It's not a certainty. Thank you. Do you have any hope?
Yes.
Please, tell me.
We think together.
Yes.
Something less
divided. Hmm.
Hmm.
can you say it again?
To exchange the word frontier to something less dividing.
Word. You have already done that. to me, because I realized how arrogant I was writing Frontier. To me, it's something I learned right now. Thank you. Frontier. Because there is some ambition in it, you know, to be on the frontier, to be on the edge. So now I am realizing this. First, I just liked the meaning of the word. Now you tell me that might divide. This is good, thank you. The word frontier
to something less dividing.
It doesn't come to my mind yet. Maybe at the end.
But you said it yourself.
What? What did they say?
You said the edge.
Ah, the edge.
And that's what it's all about, isn't it?
Together, less dividing. That's good. I feel good about it. And do you have any doubts? Well, I don't remember your name, sorry.
Claudia. Claudia,
do you have any doubt? Maybe I ask you at the end of my speech, okay? Something may come down later. Okay, come up later. Any other contribution?
Is my hope.
Your name is?
Hedwig.
Hedwig. Okay. Refer to change management and
my doubts sometimes I'm afraid it's typical problem.
So the doubt is all this connected, reflecting, or tell me the word. Is all this linked with the old project management? Project management theory, and that's okay. I have to disappoint it. It is. So be prepared. There is space. Name.
Veronica.
Okay. Okay, three doubts. I need two more. You have already.
Me?
You were smiling, you were. But I'm sure you can add a little. It doesn't take much time to you.
Okay. You know me for years, yes. I hope that it is something out of the box.
This is the hope.
Yes.
Good hope.
And my doubt is that it's Again, with the usual words, like,
that's enough. Okay, a game of or with?
A game of the usual words.
Of the usual words. Of a mix of the usual, usual words. So I will disappoint you, I guess. Be prepared. Another doubt.
I hope you would share, or you will share your wisdom.
Oh. Thank you for the assumption. I wrote share our wisdom. Do you mind?
No, I thought you might share your wisdom.
And I hope we share our wisdom. And you have any doubt?
Well, sometimes I'm asking whether there is wisdom in business.
You doubt?
Whether there is, it is possible that there is wisdom in business.
Wisdom in business. All these doubts are going to be disappointed. Okay. Okay, now I tell you why I asked these questions. First of all, to reassure me that I was connected with you. Second, because when we will divide at the end in subgroups, each subgroup will have the chance of choosing one doubt and working on it and coming back with the solution. Okay? I'm not responsible for the solution. You are. You have these feelings, you have these questions. You will have the task of giving the solution.
Like we do with our clients.
Thank you. And this is a good, this your answer is a reassuring answer, because this means that I'm coherent with the word coach. I don't have the solution. Now, I will begin with my slides. Please, if you have any observation, any comment, interrupt me, okay? Because I tend to go on when I have slides. I might go on for 10 hours, and I understand that is not the right way of interacting, you know? If we want to create something together. So I will share with you some of my experience. And my experience is this. It's summarized in a few facts. The first fact is that every year in Italy, in the last 10 years, are born more than 300,000 new enterprises. Probably something like 330,000, something like that. Statistics. And I include all the VAT codes that are created every year. You understand what I'm saying, what I'm talking about? So it may be one single person that offers his her service into the market, to the market, a restaurant, anything. Just somebody who creates his own activity with no assurance of being paid by anybody, taking the risk of going into the market and offer something, right? In the same time, slightly less number of enterprises die. And I know also that in Italy, there are more or less 3,500,000 enterprises. 90%, more than 90% of them are two, three people working together, offering service or products. Okay? Old knowledge, I believe. You are not struck by this information. I don't know about Germany, maybe something similar, I don't know. Does anybody know how many enterprises are born every year in Germany? Maybe somebody might go on the web and find out. Okay. Most of big corporates have reduced in the latest 10 years their headcounts radically in Europe. There is a trend that has not stopped yet. I'm not going to talk about the innovations and all that, because you know, but I very recently spoke with the director of human resources of an important bank in Italy. She said, we don't need 60% of the people we employ. Okay? All this make a scenario. Out of the 10 coaches I had when I began my job as a coach, 1997, 15 years, more than 18 years ago, six of them now have their own enterprise. One of them, for example, worked in Walt Disney, and he was having a global job to put together all the artwork created both in Los Angeles and in other countries, in other subsidiaries of Walt Disney, to make the possibility to exchange all this capital knowledge, all this knowledge, and avoid doubling the effort in another country to do again the same job. They had so much knowledge in their patrimony that they didn't know. So this was his job. Now, what does he do? He has his own small enterprise, and he intermediates between the large corporations in Italy and the Silicon Valley small enterprises. He favors the match, the big corporations in Italy, by the innovation, the product or something created in, you know how many people in this enterprise? Three people. They are making a lot of money. He left Walt Disney. Okay, he had a good idea, but he had to realize it outside. What am I saying? What does it mean for coaches? We have a potential market of 3 million, more than 3 million entrepreneurs, but we focus on the 200,000 people in executive jobs, for example. This is one of the considerations I offer you. Do you think that that might be a market for coaches? These 3 million people having their own ideas, business ideas, having the courage of confronting with the market. What is your opinion? Is that right? We continue to talk about executives, managers, all these people, and forget about the three, in Italy, 3 million, maybe all over Europe, 10 times. My conclusion in front of this little data, but significant, is that entrepreneurship is an horizon for most people entering or in the labor market today. The youth in Italy, either they start their own enterprise or they are likely to...
Please stay here, so when you talk over there, I can't hear you.
I'm sorry, but I have my microphone here.
It's only for recording.
It's only for recording. Okay. So I was saying, entrepreneurship is the future of work. Is the future of work. Because this trend, in my opinion, is going to double in 10 years. This is my feeling. Now, okay, now, Bernd has taught me that system is the right perspective, right? So the good, effective perspective. When we talk about coaching in organizations, if we work with somebody working in an organization, we have to consider at least two systems. The person is a system. And the organization is a system. The person is a system because, as you know, it's differentiated in terms of needs, values. Each of us know that we are a system because I myself want the opposite. I want one thing and its opposite. I want to be loved and I want to lead and to be powerful, for example. Very simple. It's not very easy to put together these two needs and these two, okay? And I want to change things, but I want things stay, be stable. So we are integrating every day our system, and we change. On the other hand, organization change, simply because people grow, they want power, they want success, or because a third system, which is even more powerful, which is the business context. For example, I was working in Olivetti. It was a very big and successful company when I worked there in the 70s, early 70s. There were 60,000 people in the world. Nowadays, disappeared. Nothing. The word, the brand is still there. So the brand could be strong yet, but the company do not exist anymore. What and why? They had a good management, they had good people. People were affectionate to their company. They loved it. As today, people who work for Google, the problem was outside, was in the context. They were in the wrong place, first of all. Italy was not an enough market, and the rules were terrible. The costs of people and everything was very high, and innovation was not rewarded. So they were alone in Italy. Even in the industrial association, they were taken apart. They tried hard for 20 years, and at the end, they collapsed. So is not enough having good management, having a good organization, having good human resources, human capital. That is not enough. That is only a part of the game. The other part is being positioned in the right place in the market, having good products, having good processes. This is a simple fact that as coaches we should print in our mind, because either we help the entrepreneurs all over, they might be in executive places, even in management, we must help them to improve their business. Their business may be just their unit, their product, but this is the challenge today, the strong challenge. By the way, we as coaches are both, because these two systems can diverge, and we are called to help people to put questions to themselves, to ask themselves, to, am I doing what is needed here? Is this the right place for me? Is this the right organizational ambience for satisfying my needs, my motivation? And there is no nothing negative if the answer is no. I am not in the right place. I have to get off, as somebody of you have done, leaving their company. Okay? So being in an organization is not a lifelong marriage anymore. Sometimes we have this criteria still, that this marriage should continue forever. And if a company tells somebody, you are not needed here anymore, this is negative. It's wrong. New things come out. New opportunities come out. We have learned that after divorcing, we may be happy. We may find happiness after the divorce. And the same is going on in the integration between organization and individual. Okay. The old paradigm, if you want to change, you had to go through all these stages. You have the good strategy. Deploy the strategy in good policies to have the right structure, the right roles, well-defined roles, and then the good systems, training system, career systems, communication systems, reward system, and so on and so forth. And the right style, management style, and the leadership style, the right culture. You know how long it takes to make all these things work together in harmony? It takes years. And there are times when you have to make a change in a few months. How is it possible to go through all these stages? Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm saying that the system may be simpler. Leverage on people directly. Forget about all this organizational infrastructure. Make it simple. It's too complicated. It's too rigid, too bureaucratic. Help people create their contribution. Help people to realize their dreams, their business ideas. This is the important thing, either in the company or in the market. I saw many organizations with a dramatically bureaucracy. Dramatic bureaucracy. Even the best, most of the best, have dramatic bureaucracies. Matrix structures. You know what matrix structures are? The biggest, the most complicated matrix. Nobody knows who is making the decision at the end. It's a complicated negotiation going on for months, and nothing happens. And the market, do you think it's waiting for this decision-making time? So, what is really important in the market is to focus people on the competitive challenges that the global economy, the technological revolution is facing corporates, or individuals, or entrepreneurs. We are all, from the biggest company to the smallest enterprise, we are all facing the same context with technological change going on every day. And there are moments when the small micro enterprise is stronger than the dinosaur. As far as the micro enterprise design the good product, the good business model, the good process, innovate. Innovation is the key word today. So we should be aware that of this need of simplification. These are the key organizational variables. Business model, who might be the target clients? Who are the target? The same question that each of us ask himself or herself if we have to go to the market. Very simple. Who are the clients? What would I do to them that is of value? What value will I be able to deliver? The questions are the same. Do I have the competencies? Am I able to have the right behaviors? The feedback is there every day. Whenever we feel some critical doubt, whenever we are uncertain, this is a feedback that we should focus on. And this is where a coach could help. This is where a coach could help the entrepreneur wherever she or he is in the company, outside the company, is to solve these questions. And we have to be coached simply. Ask the right questions. What did you, why do you have this feeling? Where did you find an answer? What did function in your experience? Can you see some resources around you or in you? The same question that we ask in coaching are there. This silence, where is me? Where I am? Where am I? Are you with me?
Sure.
No doubt?
A lot of doubts,
okay. So you are preparing yourself. Oh, yeah, reassurance. I told you, Klaus, I need you. Okay. So this is an enormous opportunity for a coach. Enormous. We have the possibility to give support to all the entrepreneurs outside or inside the corporations. Millions of people that are there and have a lot of doubts, difficulties, critical moments. And we may help them find their answer, working together. But if this is an important opportunity, as the lady there, I don't remember your name, was underlined, York, was underlined before, do we have the competencies for doing that? What are the competencies? And unfortunately, the answer is not so easy. Because if we want to be coaches able to give this kind of service, this kind of support, which is the one badly needed in the market, we need to have a good knowledge of the present business world, critical factors, trends, and it's not simple. And we have to we need the ability to read the specific environment where the entrepreneur is. Understanding of business innovation processes. We must be as expert of innovation process as we are expert of the learning problems, of the learning process, because they are strictly connected. Only the innovation process is organizational. It may be one individual, but usually is an organizational, inside the company or with a network of suppliers. Okay?
Change my branch, it takes me a lot of time to get deep inside.
Okay, you have time, you are young. You have 20 years in front of you at least of work,
but
probably 30 years of work, right?
Okay, but is it a consequence, or do you think of it, or did you work?
We have to work, we have to study. We have to improve our competencies. This is the answer. We cannot rely on just being expert of the learning process, of the fine-tuning with our client. This is important. It's not, I'm not saying it's not important. We have to add on it much. Yes?
Maybe you can help me with linking two things together.
Okay.
Right now I understood you focusing very small companies which are in the process of creating themselves.
I am focusing on Job Steve and Steve Job. We are focusing on all the individual that from one idea changes the world. We have, all of us has the possibility of changing it. Bern did change his environment, okay? He's has been training 400 people per year, right? Okay, this made a change. He's not Steve Jobs, but he's an entrepreneur who made a change.
Like the last 4 years, I made the experience most of the entrepreneurs use the business model canvas, which is like a 9-question approach developed in America from Eric Ries, which is very famous and very...
Why not?
Like the most common tool for this.
But it's
focusing different aspects. So if we try to approach or try to get in contact with this, wouldn't it be clever to focus on the tool which is mostly used for these...
Yeah, absolutely.
Which is different...
Absolutely. This is my small experience, very small. I am not proposing this as a general tool. I am not proposing here nothing as a formula, nothing. I'm just offering you my perspective. My perspective is there is a big market. Let us focus on this big market. The big market of the future is the entrepreneur market. All over the world, all over the levels of the organization, anywhere, small entrepreneurs, big entrepreneurs. But the question is for everybody, how am I able to give value to my clients? This is the simple questions. And of course, the third is still the same. Being able to manage the emotional and cognitive dimensions implied by the dynamics of change. It is always tricky. It is always emotional, always, change is emotional. And that is, if we know how to deal with that, this is a good starting point. It's a good base. The challenges, multiple knowledge base. We have to study things that are completely different from our background, maybe. Maybe. But most of you have a corporate experience, for example. So we may think back to this experience and distillate our knowledge from that, for example. Another question, another challenge is, what will I be doing with my client? Will I be a consultant? Will I be a teacher? Will I be a coach? Who cares? Just give what it's needed, right? And also, okay, again, the ability to manage the dimension, the cognitive and emotional dimension. Okay, now, at the end, let me focus what, in my experience, can be worth. Business project coaching. What it is, it's a coaching program that explicitly and specifically aim at supporting the coachee in improving together his behaviors and his contribution to the business. Okay? He can be an entrepreneur outside, alone. He can be the manager in charge of a unit. If he or she are able to improve, he is likely to improve his behaviors too. Because as somebody told this afternoon in our small group, we learn as we do things. Action learning. Somebody was talking about action learning before. I can see he acting otherwise. maybe he's okay. So I'm here to tell you old stuff. Action learning. Very old, 40 years old, but still very effective and reinforced by the cognitive science. The cognitive science tells us that we learn with our body, not with our mind only. Our mind must be connected with our heart, with our passion. If this happens, all our physical resources are involved and learn. So we must be able to create this connection. Do you agree? We'll see. We'll see later. So this is what I mean with business project coaching. Offer this service to corporates or to entrepreneurs. It is still a minority. It's not enough for saturation. It's not enough yet. I'm sure it can become. I was waiting for you because I'm selling action learning and you are.
Okay.
I'm saying that action learning is what we need. Action learning. We need to make people learn to be more and more entrepreneurial, acting in an enterprise project, in a business project. That is the way we can give help. Stimulating awareness and developing through, as all coaches do, putting the right question, the powerful question, the effective question, the challenging question. Am I late, Bernd?
No, you're on time.
Okay. Now, something more specific. Till now, I gave you a perspective. Now, what then can be done? What are the features, the key features of this method I am proposing? I will talk about the process of business project coaching. I will talk about the value results, and I will give you some examples, models and tools applied during the path of business project coaching. Okay, actually, a project is very close to project management. The project management is old, but we may cook it in a rather different way. But who cares? Why we should be always new and innovative? We have so many challenges to face that we may even use something of the old knowledge. Why not? If it is functioning. So there are, in my view, I'm not sure that the project management theory agrees with me. I don't mind. I see the project divided in these five phases. First of all, generation of a new business idea. Second, set up of a project. Otherwise, it will not work very much, not very quickly. If you set up a project, then you have a specific environment for it, a specific person, a specific group in charge. Otherwise, it will disappear quickly. We have plenty of good ideas, but the real problem is not having good ideas, having vital ideas that resist to all the difficulties, all the critics, all the challenges, all the enemies that innovation has. Then there is a phase of project development and validation. Okay, you must prove that there is money back, there is a payback, otherwise who cares? Then there is the project implementation, and if everything worked enough, you can check results. Nothing new. Now, how can we apply coaching? This is my answer. I'm not saying it's general. This is my formula. And I am open to criticism, to doubts, to questions. A first phase, well, it's a startup, okay? You must have the right relationship, as usual, with the right client, with the right coachee. You must gain trust, okay? I am not going to focus on that because we all know. But then there is a second phase, which is very important. If we explore your environment, what might be a good idea of new business? What might be a good opportunity? Okay? This is a critical phase. Second, afterwards, third phase. Then our role in this approach is help to set up the project. So we have a lot of questions to ask. Do you have supporters? Who are your stakeholders? What resources you may count on? What resources are needed? Okay, a lot of questions. And then the project must be validated by yourself, if you are an entrepreneur, or somebody else in big corporates. Then we must have a clear, precise idea of the gaps from what we have and what we need to have in terms of resources and competencies. And make a plan to collect resources or competencies. Where? Are they easy to find or not? So we will develop, we will have a development plan. And then we are almost ready to have the final decision, go or no go. What are the benefits? What are the costs? What are the risks? And from then on, it is very similar to project management. Implementation. Where the real actor is the manager. It's not us as coaches. It's not our responsibility. What are the results? What are the value? What is the value of this? Two things. If we help an individual, he will learn, he will develop competencies, he will develop together with a new business possibility, opportunity. So we'll pay back our contribution and much more than that. But the maximum value is reached in a team coaching session setting. Because if we work with maybe 6 people, 12 people, 18 people, we are talking of organization learning. We are not talking of, about a better competence for one person. We are working on organization development. On that, because people learn how to relate to each other in a different way, supporting each other in the knowledge creation. So the organizational practice is going to change if we help a group of people to have this experience much stronger. It, this value is knowledge creation, which resides in the company. And I just remind you of the Nonaka Takeuchi model, very powerful. Socialization, externalization, combination, interiorization. I'm not going to talk about this. Just remind you of the Knowledge Creating Company. Wonderful book. This is a model for innovation. All innovations need, first of all, a generation of a new idea. Otherwise, nothing. There is nothing. But all new ideas face problems. Inevitably, they face difficulties. They face obstacles. And this is the second requirement. Problem solving, solutions providing, finding a solution. Otherwise, you stop there. Then you have to be convincing others. You have to give passion to your expression. Otherwise, who cares? They are deft. If you don't arrive, nothing happens again. This is the third challenge. And then there is the challenge of implementation. If you don't manage things correctly, again, you do not arrive to the result, to the goal. These are the fourth requirements of any innovation and any change process. This has an impact on the tools, because whenever you are faced with a problem, whenever you have to conceive something new. You may refer to creative techniques. Nothing new again. There are a lot of creative techniques that may help, but this is not enough. You need validation criteria, defined in advance. If you are working in a big corporate, there must be somebody who is the investor in the company, who has the money, and he must tell what his or her expectations are in terms of criteria decision. What kind of return do we need? What are the criteria to make decisions? Then there is the moment when there must, it is most important to find a solution to a problem. And again, you can use some of the creativity, but it's not enough. I just tell you that there is a model we have created in our company that solving problem has a very strong subjective dimension. So the person must feel that he owns the problem, he or she owns the problem. He must have a clear objective to reach, must be helped to focus this objective, this goal, and then must be helped to find a way to arrive to that objective, and to test this way, and make it work in action. Try it. This is a model we use. And then there is a systemic sustainability check. Do we have the competence, the resources? There is a good balance in the whole system. Good balance between costs and benefits. When we go to the expression, it's completely different. We have to be convincing. We have to be able to keep out our strength, our energy. And this is in our body. You know the techniques? Again, techniques old, nothing new. Music. Music is the important technique. Music, chanting, singing together. We did it in a very traditional Piedmont corporation, multinational, in the food industry. Again, I'm not telling you the name of this one, but you know it very well. And these 18 engineers, mostly engineers, about 50, 55 years old, were singing together, were playing together, and they were happy as boys at the end. And they learned what the word expression means. But then, if you have to win an argument, you must be logic. You must have good arguments. So all the time, there is a challenge. Put our emotional dimension together with our reason. We are a good brain. We were born with the capacity of thinking. Use it. Engineers, use it. And this is good, but we must be at the same time engineers and humanistic. We have to put our human side together with our rational side, which means use the body resources and the brain and the mind together as a whole.
We have now more of the first hours of your term, but we only have time for this 1 hour. So
okay.
Please find somehow.
I'll try somewhere. I'll show you just a tool which I like that I can, and then maybe we can give
then we go into the groups.
Xerox. Okay. Project cards. Okay. This has a lot to do with project management. We created a set. Where is it? My jacket. Thank you. I'm beginning to be tired also. These are magical project cards. We distribute, when we work with a group of six people, for example, we distribute cards at the beginning of the first session. And in these cards, each card describes an essential feature of a project functioning. Please. It's in Italian, but you know Italian. For example, project organization, like roles, rules. In Italy, we don't like rules, I must confess. We don't like rules, right? You laugh. We do all we can to destroy rules or to overcome rules. And this may be helpful in certain moments, you know, when we need to be creative. But if we need to implement things, as Expo in Milan demonstrates, we have been able to deliver the building, the Italian building of the Expo, during the last night, okay? And in the previous 3 months, 24 hours per day working, okay? So if we use better our brain and our implementation, project management skills, rules, probably it would be much better. And so I hope in the future to have the possibility of putting together Germans and Italians, maybe some Swiss also, even some Swiss. Okay? So these project cards is the last slide. We give them, we distribute them, and we say, do you like the cards you have? Yes, so and so, these I don't like. Okay, put this card on the table, and maybe there is somebody else who is ready to give you another card. So it's like in Monopoly, do you remember Monopoly? Okay, it's a play, it's a game, but this makes people acquainted with the rules of project management quickly. It takes 1 hour of play, and at the end they have clearer idea on their own responsibilities, on the rules of the game, and how they must behave in the activity of the project. Okay, thank you very much. Now, I am finished. Thank you, Clara.